So I, my name is Imelda Turner, and I live just a few blocks from here. And I was scheduled to give this message a few months ago, and I thought, oh, maybe the Lord, and it didn't happen. And I thought, maybe the Lord is showing me something. Maybe I shouldn't be giving this message. And then God spoke to me and said, I chose you for a particular reason. And he keeps reminding me, it's not about me. It's about him, our Lord Jesus Christ. As much as I want to think that this message is coming from me, it's not. It's coming from God. He's instructed me. In our Sunday school meeting this morning, we talked about people being anointed. And I am so grateful to God that God has worked in my heart to be able to be part of this church, first of all, and to be able to give my testimony, because not everybody is going to feel comfortable giving their testimony, sharing about what God has done in my life. And sometimes I say, Lord, well, why did you save me? I was so lost in this world, and I did some pretty stupid stuff. But he said, it doesn't matter what you've done in the past, that I'm a new creation. And I say, I am a new creation. And I've been so blessed because I've heard and followed Jesus Christ through my walk. I'd first like to start with an opening prayer. Lord Jesus, you are worthy of all honor and praise. Help us to love as you do, and to act wisely so that others will be drawn to your salvation and hope. May we build and encourage each other today and every day as we give you all the glory, Lord. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. I would first of all like to thank Pastor Jeremy and Pastor Jody for their confidence in my walk with Jesus Christ. It is through our public testimony that we please God. I also want to give credit to one of my favorite online pastors. Her name is Sarah Jakes Roberts, as some of her sermons gave me the inspiration for my message today. She's an anointed child of God. I'm not sure how many of you were at the service when I spoke about my recent incident in my home in Montreal. First of all, I would like to give God glory for blessing my family and I with a home in Canada. We had a severe storm on August 9th that ended up causing major flooding in many parts of the city, including my neighborhood in Dorval. I, along with many other neighbors, had 2 to 3 feet water in our basement. I had never seen anything like it before. I was in Vancouver at the time visiting some friends, so I knew I couldn't do anything. But thank God that I have a front door neighbor, Eunice, who has been such a blessing to my family. She went out, bought a pump, and pumped water out of 3 homes that day. It was Friday, August 9th. She is such an angel. And I knew there was nothing that I could have done from Vancouver. I prayed to God that he sent his angels to protect our community homes. I know it could have been worse and have flooded entire homes like we have seen throughout the U.S., where only the rooftops are shown in the news. But thank God this was only my basement. I have to give God credit for all the people that he brought into my life the next several weeks to help with the cleanup. But I couldn't help but ask, why did this happen to me, Lord, to us in this neighborhood? I've got to be honest and say that I experienced some anxiety for the first few days after the incident. I thought, what am I supposed to do? I started to think about needing to take time off from work to clean up the mess and to make calls to the insurance company and to make calls to the furnace people. My furnace was 2 feet underwater during this time. And then I quickly reminded myself, I knew that was God's child. I had to remind myself, and I had to remind myself that I needed to call on God. He's my superhero for his help. I silenced myself long enough to be still, to ask God for his direction in this situation, because I didn't know what I was going to do. I asked that he calm my mind to show me what I needed to do going forward. I cried out to God and asked for his mercy and peace in my heart. I knew that was going to be the only way I could go forward with this situation in hand. The basement went from a beautiful finished basement to an unfinished space. During my stillness, I heard God say to me that I'd be a catalyst to change how things had been done in the past. He says, I'm sending you to act differently during the storm. He told me I'd be an overcomer. He reminded me to be God-focused and not self-focused. I thought, Lord, if you're calling me to be the catalyst for my family, I'm going to leap up, step forward, and trust you. That's how it works, I said. The challenges in life enable us to get down on our knees and demand from God and say, I know there's something I need to learn from this. Help me. Show me. What do I need to do? Give me clarity, Lord, on who I am to become this season. This was my next season. 2 Corinthians 5:17 states that anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life and things of the earth are gone. A new life has begun. So then God gave me the revelation that I was not to worship stuff. What was lost was just stuff. I was okay. My family was okay. Nobody died, thank God, during this flood. And that he was going to make things new. And boy, has he made things new indeed. Thank God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We serve a God of exhilaration. Sometimes we need a shakeup in order for us to grow. God wants to see how fast he can change the direction of our destiny. He will continue to protect us while he exposes us. Sometimes he needs to make us raw in order for us to better understand our next season. God wants to exhilarate us into our next season of growth. Something happens when I worship, when I pray. The depression backs off from me. The anxiety breaks away. Deliverance is contagious. It becomes overflow. It touches my family, my home, my office. It will deliver us from God's, it will deliver us with God's right hand. He will loosen the Holy Spirit to fight the spirit that's trying to break us. I want to be delivered from the bondage and generational curses of my father, my mother, and of our culture. I plead the blood of Jesus over anxiety, over every disease and every finance. I pray that our Heavenly Father helps us to recognize the beautiful and powerful men and women he has created us to be. As long as we stay surrendered and connected to him, we will always have access to the power and strength we need to show up in the fullness of who he wants us to be every single day. We ask that God's voice speak louder than any lie the enemy may try to tell us, from standing in the power and authority that the good Lord has given to us. God wants to deliver us from the past that keeps us in bondage. The enemy is after our worship. He's after our prayer life. Prayer creates an atmosphere of God's power and strength to kill the enemy's power. Anxiety must flee when we worship and pray. I will not live in the atmosphere of insecurity and fear. I will not live in bondage. I refuse in Jesus' name. With God's help, I can crush the head of the enemy. My family couldn't do it, but I will stop the generational curse. The curse that sent my family into depression, anxiety, and addictions. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. Amen. As long as we stay connected and surrendered to God, we have to give it up to Him. And I did. Thank you, Lord. Life can be messy, and the only way to survive the world we live in is to maintain a personal relationship with God. This is the place of rest that God has made for us. I don't want to just survive. I want to thrive. It's God's promise. And it's only through our Lord Jesus Christ that it's possible. We must surrender to God's will. I need to be able to walk away from ego and pride in order to become the person God wants me to become. Help me, Lord, to walk in the way of your wisdom, trusting you no matter what happens in my life. Know that steadfast trust in you, Jesus, is essential for finding and following the right path. As I go along my journey, I encounter many things that seem random or wrong. Yet, I believe you are fitting all of these things into a comprehensive plan. Your master plan for my life. I realize I only see a very small piece of a big picture that God has painted for me. From my limited vantage point, my journey sometimes seems confusing with puzzling twists and turns. But I'm learning to walk by faith, not by sight, trusting that you are indeed leading me along straight paths. Thank you, Lord. I continue to pray that God unleash the power, His power within me. He preserves me and makes a way out where there is no way possible. He is a miracle worker. He is the great I am. God gives me peace and joy to know that I am His child, and He won't leave me nor forsake me. God will help me thrive in my home and my community. I will not let fear be my God. It stops with me because I want my son and daughter to know that they don't have to fear when they believe in God. And my kids still haven't come to know Jesus Christ, but every day I pray for their salvation. I want them to know the joy that I have in my heart, because without our Lord Jesus Christ, there is no true love, no true joy. It's all pretend. People may say that they're happy, they're content, but if they don't know our Lord Jesus Christ, it's all superficial. Surrender yourself for more. In Luke 9:18 through 20, Jesus looks at his disciples and says, "Who do you say I am?" We have a tendency to keep God in a box. Okay, Lord, so I'll praise you and I'll worship you Monday through Friday. Then the weekend comes and I'm going to take a break from worshiping you. That's not what God wants us to do 24/7 with our God. 24/7. In order to truly appreciate the fullness of who God is and who He wants us to become, we have to have a solid divorce from who we have been known to be. The old is gone, the new has come in. We have to recalibrate our compass, our obedience, engage in righteous thinking, disengage from the gossip, disengage from talking about others. If we can't lift anybody, move away from it. And He wants us to ignite the Spirit of God within us. That's what's going to keep us going every single day. Ignite the Holy Spirit within us. We must ask again, What is our discipleship? Who do we follow? Selflessness or selfishness? Let's not forget, through Jesus Christ's finished work on a cross, we can depend on him for his resurrection life to pulsate and flow into our physical body, from the crown of our head to the soles of our feet. Sickness and disease are not from God. On the cross, Jesus bore not just our sins, but also our sicknesses, our diseases, our infirmities. And by his stripes, we are healed. Thank God. Thank God. That's not all. On the cross, Jesus bore the curse of poverty. He doesn't want us to be poor. This is what the word of God declares. For you know the unmerited favor of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, for our sake he became poor, that you, through his poverty, might become rich. 2 Corinthians 8, verse 9. We are truly blessed. When the storm begins to encompass your daily living, ignite your faith in God and God's mercy and goodness. Get down on your knees and say, Lord, I can't do this by myself. I know you saved me for a reason. I am here. Take me. Take me. He is pleased when our faith is big. Don't ask God for little stuff. He wants to give us the big stuff. He really does. Ask him for a long and healthy life filled with many good days. Ask our God who hung the planets in their places and spoke order into the world. God who led his people in a pillar of cloud by day and pillar of fire by night. God who rained manna from heaven and brought forth water from dry rock. Like, this is our God. Ask big. The God who turned bland waters into the finest wines. He who made the lame walk, the blind see, and the deaf to hear. This is our God. Our God who raised the dead and conquered the grave. Let heaven and earth proclaim, this is our God, King Jesus. What else do we need in this world? When we know that God loves us and will give anything for us, all we have to do is ask. And like he said, ask for the big stuff. The little stuff will come, but ask in God's name for the big stuff. That is my message for today. And I am just so grateful to God that he's using me, once again, someone who was lost and has been found, to share his message. I'm not perfect. I'm not perfect at all. I ask God for forgiveness when I engage in gossip. Please forgive me, Lord. He knows we're human, and he does forgive us. But always know that we can ask for his forgiveness, because if we don't, we'll backslide and we'll go back so far that we can't, or we feel that we can't come back to him, even though he's got open arms for us and he's willing to accept us anytime. All we have to say is, Lord, help me, help me. And the good Lord can take away all the earthly goods. And as long as I have him, I know I will be okay. My family will be okay. I may be sad and say, Lord, why me again? And he's gonna say, why not? I've groomed you to become who you are. So when things happen to you, don't say, why me? Why not? I'm a 10-year cancer survivor. And I remember that day when I got the diagnosis. And the first thing I said, Lord, forgive me, I said, why me? And then very quickly, he said, I knew you were the woman for the job. And he knows that every single person in here is the person for the job that he sends. If he sends bad things to happen in our life, he knows that you are the person for the job. Do not ever doubt that God has given us the glory and the mercy and the peace, that we are going to put on that armor of God every single day. We're going to walk in his favor. We are going to not be ashamed of our God. Don't back down when people question who your God is, because your God is bigger than their God. Amen. We don't know who their God is, but we know who our God is. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We know who our God is. So as my closing prayer, thank you, Lord, for the gift of grace that you bestow upon us through Christ's death and resurrection, and your Holy Spirit, Lord, that lives within us, guiding our decisions. Help us to remember that your unconditional love and divine protection as we journey into the new day, Lord. In your name we pray, Jesus, and we continue to ask that you protect our community families, protect our homes, Lord, protect our nation that is in so dire need of your love and mercy, Lord. Just continue to open doors for people who are lost. Continue to just heal, Lord, and bring your blessings from the heavens into our earth, exactly where they are needed. I'd like to end my message. I'd like to encourage each and every one of us to continue to worship God this morning. There's a song by Kirk Franklin, and it's called "It's Going to Be a Lovely Day." Let's make today and every day a lovely day and rejoice, for our God is good. He's alive, and he only wants the best for us. I'd like for everybody to stand up, and if you want to dance to this, I love to dance to this song every morning. He makes my day. It's going to be a lovely day every single day. We choose to make it a lovely day or not. So let us just give thanks to God that he puts people into our presence who have beautiful voices and have messages for us. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. And I think the lyrics will be on the screen. Please just feel free. Oh, yeah. Wake up in the morning, love, and my heart is filled with pain. And upon my face is gone. See the bloodshed of my pain. I think of you. And what walk right with me. Lord, just one thought of you. And I know it's gonna be a lovely day. Lovely day. Lovely day, lovely day, lovely day. Lovely day, lovely day. Lovely day. Lovely day. Jesus, you're the lover of my soul. The fire that turns the wind in me. You're the joy this world can't take away. Your spiritual love affair has never been for end. Woo! Think of you. I think of you. Crawl with right. Just one thought of you. I know it's gonna be a lovely day. Lovely day, lovely day. Woo! Wipe your tears. Lovely day, lovely day. I know you're going through the steps now. You're like giving up now. How can you stay on? Don't fall. You walk with your shoulder crossed. See me, you're repressing me, and they're obsessed in me. Or are they catching? Woo! I think of you. When I think of you, they all cried, we're right with. Would you bring to? It's gonna be. Woo! Lovely day, lovely day. Jesus! Lovely day now. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you.